So Goldilocks has been arrested, and what we need to decide before we start the trial is what crimes from that story did Goldilocks commit?
We're excited to be here at Santa Fe Trail Elementary School. We are introducing Constitution Day, which we have typically in our courts, but now we're taking it to the schools. So we're going to talk to the students about the Constitution, the three branches of government, and then we're going to do a mock trial. Let them have an opportunity to see and experience what a trial would be like. So I have three judges with me. I have an attorney, and we have an actual court reporter here as well.
That lady as the person who is sleeping in the bed.
Someone stating that my client is guilty is unfair, and I think that they should provide proof.
Last week was Celebrate Freedom Week, and we took a lot of time to talk about the Constitution, and with having that conversation about the government and rules, I feel like today with our mock trial, it really just brought all of those ideas to life for our kids. They were able to kind of see in real time what the judicial branch looks like.
Yes. Have a seat, please.
Well, it was fun and educational because I didn't know anything about court type stuff, but it was fun because I got to defend a person, and then knowing that you've won is amazing.
I just thought this today would just be boring. It wasn't really. It was a learning, educational thing that was just phenomenal. It just, they just put it in a way kids would enjoy and laugh about and remember.
The jury has found our defendant guilty of burglary.
And not guilty of theft.
And not guilty of theft.
Or destruction of property.
Or destruction of property.
And say thank you, the jury may now be excused.
Thank you, now the jury may be excused.
And we are adjourned.
And we are adjourned.
Okay, this is a big win for the defendant. Huge!
Yeah.